Hi guys. I'd like to apologize if I offended any vegans or vegetarians in the last video. That really wasn't my intention. I mean, it's not that I find a problem or I find something wrong with vegetarianism or veganism. I mean, I disagree with it personally, but you know, I can respect your beliefs. It's just PETA in specific that I have a problem with. The way they market their beliefs, I guess you could call it. The way they try to push their beliefs on other people, I don't know, it just doesn't seem very respectful. I mean, you know, I'm all for protecting the environment and reducing consumption and consumerism and all that stuff. In fact, I'd probably go vegetarian myself if it weren't for the fact that, you know, I love eating meat. Just because of the core belief system. I mean, not necessarily because I think that, it's immoral to eat animals. That's not my position. I just, it's unhealthy. And, you know, on a personal basis, I need to lose weight, let's be honest. And if I could stop eating meat, I probably would. But, you know, we just don't all have that kind of willpower. But yeah, PETA. I think we can all agree that PETA sucks. I mean, if I have any PETA members in my audience, you know, I'm very sorry, but I mean, you're basically a member of a cult. I mean, okay, that's a little harsh. It's not a very ethical group, I don't think. People for the ethical treatment of animals aren't very ethical at all. So yeah, that's enough of a tangent. Let's play the game. Here we are, Super Mario Bros. 3. And holy shit, look at that. Everything's gigantic. Wow. This is pretty cute. In a world where everything is giant, you know, the big boss bass is just, you know, a normal tiny little fish. That's pretty clever. Alright, come on, Flamey. Flamey, plant. How do I want to go about this? Let's do this. Whoa! Hey, it's still the PAL music instead of the invincibility music. That's kind of odd. Whoa! There's lots of them now. Holy crap. Ah, 56 extra lives. I'm doing pretty well. Pretty well. Pokemon, his contents will help you on your way. And it's a leaf. That's something that might actually help me. Instead of a freaking worthless mushroom. A crappy toadstool. Whoa! These guys are earth-shaking. Aww, bogus. Bogosity. My bogosity meter is giving me a readout of over 5,000 bogons. That's a lot of bogons, you guys. What's a bogon, you ask? Why, it's a unit of measure, roughly equal to, I forget what the scale is. Whoa. I think a bogon is one bank employee, so 5,000 bogons would be pretty bogus. I don't know what I'm saying. I need to stop talking. It's late, I'm tired. It's 5 in the morning. Have you ever been doing an LP at 5 in the morning and just your mind doesn't work the same way anymore? I mean, sure, I'm doing good at the game, but, you know, This is just burned into my brain. I'm running on autopilot here. I'm sure there's, oops, the odd thing that I don't remember, but I mean, for the most part, I don't really even have to think when I play this game. Flowers. When you were young, you were the king of carrot flowers. And we have another one of these guys, whatever his name is. You can also kill them by hitting them with a fire flower. Surprisingly few times, actually. I didn't think I'd kill them that quickly. You may be wondering what's down in that red mushroom house in the lower right. I wonder that myself. I've never actually gotten that mushroom house because I never have a hammer on this level. I always use it on the previous level to go over and get all the stuff in the other mushroom houses. Alright. See if I can pull this off. Nope. Two mouths? It's a mutant, I tell ya. Oh no, I hate this level. Freaking Latiku. Freaking spiny things. If we had a frog suit, we could go down to the left, and I'm sure there's something awesome down there. I don't know what it is offhand, but it's probably better than anything else this level has to offer. Sheesh. Oh, I don't like Latiku very much, in case you couldn't tell. Luckily, when you kill him, he goes away for a pretty decent amount of time. He comes back eventually. Yep, there he is. Right on cue. This game has some awesome artificial intelligence. I say he'll be back, and what do you know? He brings him back. We haven't seen AI like this since the movie, AI. Starring Haley Joel Osment as a creepy little robot kid. Remember that? Steven Spielberg and Stanley Kubrick worked on it. I liked it up until the last, 15 minutes or so. It feels like Steven Spielberg took the darker sort of imagery that Stanley Kubrick was using, and he had to tack on a happy ending there. I mean, that would have been just fine if the movie ended, 15 minutes before it did. Oh, we have an awful lot of stuff. And now we're going to get even more stuff. Oh, Hammer Brothers, don't ever change. And a star. So useless. Oh, get ready. Get ready to rumble. And a P-Wing, the most useful item in the game that we're not going to use for many, many more levels. I have time to do one more. Probably. Oops. You stupid Koopa. Koopa? More like Stupa. Aw, the bullet bills won't get to be giant. Oh no, but they get the special flashing bullets. That's better. They seek you out and destroy you. They're Mario-seeking missiles. I think I heard a plant growing. Hello, what have we here? A tanuki suit! Yes! I love the tanuki suit. It basically works exactly like just having a normal leaf power-up does, but you can turn into a statue and clobber stuff. Even these things. Clobber. Oh, I love my tanuki suit. I forgot that there was one on this level. That's pretty cool. Little unexpected surprise. Alright, and that does it for this edition of Let's Play Super Mario Bros. 3. Tune in next time when we play level 6, the castle, and finish up the world. Finish up Giant World. See ya!